bishop of...
Oh, Lord. This is the title to the land and everything else. Thank you. Father Dante Barcelona, open the doors to Christ. Let us enter the church with thanksgiving and songs of praise.
bishop will now bless the water that will be used to bless us, the walls of the church, and the altar. This water reminds us of our repentance of our sins, our baptism and cleansing of the walls and altar of the church.
Sisters and brothers in Christ, in this solemn rite of dedication, let us ask the Lord our God to bless this water created by his hand. It is a sign of our repentance, a reminder of our baptism, and a symbol of cleansing of these walls and this altar. God of mercy, you call every creature to the light of life and surround us with such great love that when we stray, you continually lead us back to Christ our head. For you have established an inheritance of such mercy that those sinners who pass through the water made sacred die with Christ and rise restored as members of his holy, of his body, and heirs of his eternal covenant. Bless this water, sanctify it, as it is sprinkled upon us and throughout this church, make it a sign of the saving waters of baptism, by which we become one in Christ, temples of the Holy Spirit. May all here today, and all those in days to come, will celebrate your mysteries in this church, be united at last in the holy city of your peace. We ask this in the name of Jesus the Lord.
Amen.
May God, the Father of mercies, dwell in this house of prayer. May the grace of the Holy Spirit cleanse us, for we are the temple of his presence.
Amen.
Gloria in excelsis Deo. May strengthen here the hearts of all the faithful. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated. Let us now prepare ourselves to listen to the word of the Lord in the liturgy of the word.
May the word of God always be heard in this place as it unfolds the mystery of Christ before you and achieves your salvation within the church.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Micah. The Lord says, "You, Bethlehem, Ephrathah, too small to be among the clans of Judah, from you shall come forth for me one who is to be ruler in Israel, whose origin is from of old, from ancient times. Therefore, the Lord will give them up until the time when she who is to give birth has born, and the rest of his brethren shall return to the children of Israel. He shall stand firm, and the shepherd his flock by the strength of the Lord, in the majestic name of the Lord his God, and they shall remain. For now his greatness shall reach to the ends of the earth. He shall be peace." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The apostles returned to Jerusalem from the mount called Olivet, which is near Jerusalem, a Sabbath day's journey away. When they entered the city, they went to upper room where they were staying, Peter and John and James and Andrew, Philip and Thomas, Bartholomew and Matthew, James, son of Alphaeus, Simon the Zealot, and Judas, son of James. All these devoted themselves with one accord to prayer, together with some women and Mary, the mother of Jesus and his brothers. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please all rise.
Deserving of all praise, from you rose the Son of Justice, Christ our God. Alleluia.
She was found with child through the Holy Spirit. Joseph, her husband, since he was a righteous man, yet unwilling to expose her to shame, decided to divorce her quietly. Such was his intention when, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary, your wife, into your home, for it is through the Holy Spirit that this child has been conceived in her. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet, "Behold, the virgin shall be with child and bear a son, and they shall name him Emmanuel," which means God is with us. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated.
kahapon sa inyong tanan. I got emotional when I came in from the highway, and for the first time I saw the church at this stage. I have seen it many times, but only partially. Every time we pass this highway, I used to peep always through the sugar cane, but you see only a part. And then our driver is very fast, no? Sometimes fast and furious, really, so I miss it. But this time, as we entered, I saw this beautiful church, so imposing. Amogali ini ang church ng a lady of Medjugorje dito sa Bosnia. And because I was told by Tony and Chona that they replicated the church to the least detail, dimensions, everything that you see here is as you would see in the shrine of Our Lady there in Medjugorje. It's a real gift, and I really thank Tony and Chona and the whole Montinola family for this great, great generosity. We don't have to go anymore to Medjugorje. May ara na din, no? Amuman katahom, no? And I'm sure the presence of our Blessed Mother will be equally full here as it is there, no? So thank you very much, Tony and Chona and the family. When Tony first mentioned that he had this plan, I was happy, but I'm sorry, I was a little skeptical because I'm like Thomas, no? It's too good to be true. And he said that next year we will have it. I said, next year. And so I remember last year, we had the groundbreaking here. And I said, oh, we hope it will rise. And true indeed, in a year's time, here it is. Unbelievable. Thank you very much, Tony and Chona, for this. You know, I had a, I don't know, it might be a bad idea, no? As I was sitting here, sabi ko, in a year's time, who's able to put up this church so beautiful and practically complete, no? Siling ko, damo sa ang parokya da, way pa natapos, no? Dalapuson pa, no? And years, siling ko, siguro himoon ko si Tony nga honorary parishioner of that parish of unfinished church, siguro. I hope he will consider that. So, thank you very much. But I was even more touched when at the opening rite, before we opened the door, Tony presented to me all the papers. And his words, they were spontaneous because there was nothing in the rite. His words were, "The gift of God I turn over to you as a gift." And then I realized why the family is so generous, because it's not the only donation they gave to the church. Many others, the Marian missionaries are beneficiaries, and many other institutions, no? So then I finally realized that bottomless heart of goodness, of generosity, is a heart that knows what it holds, that all are God's gifts. And thank you very much for this, Tony, because this is precisely the spirituality we would like to live in our diocese, the spirituality of stewardship, that all that we have comes from God, and we are only stewards. That was the theme last year. Gifted to give. What do you have that you have not received? And if you have received it, why do you claim it as your own? St. Paul tells us in his letter. And that's the whole point of all that we have and all that we are, our life itself. And Tony and Chona and the family lived it very, very radically. So thank you, not only for this gift, but for the message you give us through your life. And then this gift of this church that he turns over to the diocese, as well as the land, comes with a bonus, because he had only one, because I said, Tony, you want to build a church, you have any condition or requirement for us if we are to receive? He says, I ask only one thing, Bishop, that it be administered by the Franciscan fathers and brothers. And when he said that, I said, thank God. Because, the reason, of course, is because the original shrine in Medjugorje is administered by the Franciscans. And so, not only he wanted to replicate the church, but the whole reality of Medjugorje, you know, with the Franciscan spirituality and so forth. So I was very happy, because this is another gift to the diocese, that finally the Franciscans are with us. We have a number of religious men, religious, but not too many. We have more women religious. They always outnumber us. I don't know for what reason. Even Franciscans, we already have two or three. Here you can see four. And I can keep count, no? So we have already Franciscan sisters here, but we have no Franciscan men, no? So thank you very much for coming and for accepting the invitation of the family of the Montinola, and also our invitation, no? And that's the reality. Maybe also in heaven we will, the men will be outnumbered by women, okay? Already even here, at one glance, you see, no? So may our tribe increase, no? Okay. I just like to share two reflections, which I shared also this morning. This morning I was in, they asked me to give the homily at the blessing of the new cathedral in Kabangkalan. And I share the same, I'd like to share the same reflection. On the feast we are celebrating, kag santo gid, swak na swak sa aton nga ginahiwat na blessing of the church. Ano gid ang kahulugan sang pagbata ni Maria nga siya nataw diri sa duta? What's the significance of her life? That it's something different from ours. Her birth, her life is special, because through her, God would enter into this world and insert himself into human history. Paagi sa iya, makasulod ang Diyos diri sa duta kag sa aton nga mga katawhan. Before we entered, the bishop was to say, Father Dante Barcelona, open the doors to Christ. Those of you that still recite the litany of the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Loreto litany, the titles, the many titles of Mary, remember that one of the titles is Janua Celi, Gate of Heaven. Mary is the gate of heaven, the door through which God entered into our world and became one of us. And that is why at the end of the gospel, even if the angel announced to Joseph, you will name him Jesus, at the end of the gospel, his first name mentioned long before he was born and already named in the Old Testament was again recalled. Emmanuel, God with us. Through Mary, God was able to enter and share in our humanity and became one of us, becoming our Emmanuel. And how did this happen? What did Mary do? Literally nothing. And not just he did nothing, but he was totally nothing. She was totally nothing. And that is why God could enter through her. Thomas Merton said that the chief glory of Mary is her nothingness. We sang it beautifully, led by the very beautiful rendition of our cantor, the Magnificat. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is His name. All that is happening in me, all this greatness, Mother of God and all that, it's the Lord's work. And in that same Magnificat, she says, the Lord has looked on His servant in her nothingness. The chief glory of Mary is her nothingness. 2 days ago, or 3 days ago, was it? 2 days ago, we had a recollection. The priests, we held it in the Carmelite, and we were so blessed with our speakers, two very deep souls. For our speakers, we had Mother May, the superior of the Carmelite sisters, nuns there, and Father Pau, a Carmelite spiritual director, equally very, very profound. And they shared with us the spirituality of Carmel, which when we listen to it, seems to be very simple. The spirituality is, we have a God who wants to give Himself totally to us. Who wants to fill us with Him, His presence and His power. St. John of the Cross always refers to God as the all-bestowing God. Luya kay ihatag iya kaugalingon sa atong. Bilog, tanan hasta iya pagka-Diyos ipambit sa atong. Isa lang din ang kinahanglan, agud siya makapuno sa atong sang iya presensya, kag iya kabuhi, iya kahom. And it is a space na makasulod siya. Because our heart is often kagutok, puno-puno sang, I don't know, all the desires and attachments, all the pride and lust and all that. So empty this. In one word, empty our heart of self. And that's what Jesus says. The Paschal Mystery is all about. Kag kun ina, empty git, makasulod siya. And He will really fill it. And that is Mary. The Lord has looked on His servant in her nothingness. Henceforth, all ages will call me blessed. So this blessing of this beautiful church reminds us that the Lord wants to fill us with Himself, His life, and His power. The church we bless is just a symbol of the church that He wants to stay in. We are the temples of God. As we heard it in the Rite. We are the temples of the Holy Spirit. And makasulod ang Diyos sa aton kung kita handa nga mag-aw na, mangin, mapainupuson, Panginoon, humble, detached. And the second reflection I had, which again is a beautiful, beautifully illustrated by this event of the blessing of these churches. In these past days, we have been talking and reflecting about synodality. And I'm very happy in our diocese, practically all our parishes, no? And right down to the Katilingbans, no? We had that experience of synodality. A beautiful, beautiful call of Francis, Pope Francis, to the whole church to relearn the reality of the church, not only as an institutional, hierarchical, but a synodal church. One people of God, united in Christ, walking together towards Him. And I was thinking, come to think of it talaga, no? Synodality started with the birth of Mary. That's what I realized. Kaya nga, ano yung synodality? Dunga nagapanglakaton. Sino nagapangulo sa aton? Si Jesus. Nga, diyan kita niya dalho sa iya amay. And this is the whole meaning of synodality, communion, because we are one body of Christ, united by the Holy Spirit, whom we receive in baptism, and walking together, led by Christ, and the mission of Christ in leading us in this journey is to bring us to the Father. Communion, participation, amuna ka kinanglan, kaisa kita, kabahin kita sa simbahan, we help in building up this body of Christ, in making it grow and making it prosper. And for the mission of walking towards God and bringing all our brothers and sisters, even those not in the faith, to this mission, ultimate mission of bringing to God. San unag sugod ining pagpanglakaton? San nakakita na ang Diyos sa puwertahan? Diin siya makasulod sa aton ng mga katawhan. And Mary is indeed the gate of heaven. Not only for us to enter into, but for Him to come out and be one with us and become our Emmanuel. And this is beautifully lived out in this liturgy, not only explained, but celebrated. I hope that this beautiful structure, I'm sure very soon people will come here because our people love to commune with God in places that are very conducive, that are very inviting, that where they feel the presence of God. I hope that this church will help our people in becoming more aware in this beautiful reality and call of our being the true temples of God and of our union and participation in the mission that has been given to us. We are the church that the Lord wishes to bless more than this beautiful structure. And that is my prayer. And because this has become a reality, this gift of this beautiful church through the generosity of the Montinola family, I ask this congregation that we offer this Holy Mass for the family in gratitude to them for the gift of God that they received, that they passed on to us, God's people. And let's pray also for the Franciscan fathers and brothers who will be the ones to minister, those who will come to this, who will come to to receive the sacraments and the word in this church, that they may truly be instruments leading all of us closer to God.
Please all rise.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, God from true God, begotten of me, consubstantially, through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, and who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism
for forgiveness of sins,
and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Dearly beloved, let us pray to God, the Almighty Father, who makes the hearts of the faithful into spiritual temples for himself. And may the supplication of the saints, our brothers and sisters, be joined with our voices. Please all kneel.
Saint Athanasius,
Saint
Jesus and Saint Dominic, Saint Francis Xavier, Saint John Vianney, Saint Teresa of Avila, Saint Maria Goretti, Saint Scholastica, Saint Catherine of Siena, Saint Teresa of Jesus, Saint Rose of Lima, Saint Louis Marilla, Saint Margaret Mary Alacoque, Saint Teresa of Calcutta, Saint Lorenzo Ruiz de Manila, Saint Pedro Calunso, Saint John Paul II, Saint John the 23rd, Saint Sebastian, Saint Rose, Saint Diego of Alcala, Saint Nicholas of Tolentino, Saint Thomas of Villanova, Saint Peter Baptist, Saint Matthew, Saint Anthony of Padua, Saint John Nepomucene, Saint Jude Thaddeus, Saint Anthony Abbot, Saint Vincent Ferrer, Saint Dominic Savio, Saint Vincent of Saragossa, Saint John Bosco, Saint Isidore the Laborer, Saint Helen, all holy men and women. Lord, be merciful. Together in peace and true harmony.
Mercifully accept our petition, we pray, O Lord. Through the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary and all the saints, so that this building to be dedicated to your name may be a house of salvation and grace where the Christian people gather as one, will worship you in spirit and in truth, and be built up in charity. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please all stand. The celebration of the Eucharist is the most important and the only needed ritual for the dedication of the Church. But there is a special prayer that is being said. This prayer signifies the will to dedicate the Church for the Lord.
O God, sanctifier and ruler of your Church, it is right for us to celebrate your name in joyful proclamation, for today your faithful people desire to dedicate to you, solemnly and for all time, this house of prayer, where they worship you devoutly, are instructed by your word, and are nourished by the sacraments. This house brings to light the mystery of the Church, which Christ made holy by the shedding of his blood, so that he might present her to himself as a glorious bride, a virgin resplendent with integrity of faith, a mother made fruitful by the power of the Spirit. Holy is the Church, the chosen vine of the Lord, whose branches fill the whole world, and whose tendrils, born on the wood of the cross, reach upward to the kingdom of heaven. Blessed is the Church, God's dwelling place with human race, a holy temple built of living stones, standing upon the foundations of the apostles, with Jesus Christ its chief cornerstone. Exalted is the Church, a city set high on a mountain for all to see, resplendent to every eye, with the unfading light of the Lamb, and resounding with the sweet hymn of the saints. Therefore, O Lord, we beseech you, graciously pour forth from heaven your sanctifying power upon this Church and upon this altar, to make this forever a holy place, with a table always prepared for the sacrifice of Christ. Here may the flood of divine grace overwhelm human offenses, so that your children, Father, being dead to sin, may be reborn to heavenly life. Here may your faithful gathered around the table of the altar celebrate the memorial of the Paschal mystery and be refreshed by the banquet of Christ's word and his body. Here may the joyful offering of praise resound with human voices joined to the song of angels, and unceasing prayers rise up to you for the salvation of the world. Here may the poor find mercy, the oppressed attain freedom, and all people be clothed with the dignity of your children until they come exultant to the Jerusalem which is above. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. The anointing of the Holy Chrism in the altar and the walls of the Church is a symbol of Christ, who was anointed as the High Priest, who offered his life for the salvation of all. The anointing of the Church signifies that this place is reserved in all times for liturgical celebrations of the Church only.
May the Lord, by his power, sanctify this altar and this house, which by our ministry we anoint, so that as visible signs they may express the mystery of Christ and the Church.
The incensation of the altar symbolizes the sacrifice of Christ, a mystery that continues up to this time. This has become a fragrance that reaches up to heaven. It also symbolizes the prayers of the people being lifted to the throne of God.
Let our prayer rise, O Lord, like incense in your sight. And as this house is filled with a pleasing fragrance, so let your church be fragrant with the aroma of Christ.
Thank you.
covering the altar with cloths holds specific meaning in the church and acts as a unifying symbol to Catholic worshipers throughout the world, an altar in which we gather to commemorate the death and resurrection of Christ.
Let the light of Christ shine brightly in the church, that all nations may attain the fullness of truth.
The tabernacle is a place of the church that holds the ciborium containing the Eucharist. This makes a tabernacle the heart and the cornerstone of each church. It is the reference of those who come to pray and worship the body of Christ even outside of celebrations. The tabernacle, God's presence.
Lord and Father of all holiness, from whom the true bread from heaven has come down to us, bless us and the tabernacle we have prepared for the sacrament of Christ's body and blood. Through our adoration of your Son present in the Eucharist, lead us to a closer union with the mystery of redemption. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
preparing the altar, all of us, together with the bishop and the priests, will celebrate the Eucharist, which is the center of this whole ritual. The Eucharist is the source and summit of the Christian life. The other sacraments, and indeed all ecclesiastical ministries and works of the apostolate, are bound up with the Eucharist and are oriented toward it. For in the Blessed Eucharist is contained the whole spiritual good of the Church, namely Christ Himself, our Pasch. By the Eucharistic celebration, we already unite ourselves with the heavenly liturgy and anticipate eternal life, when God will be all in all. In brief, the Eucharist is the sum and summary of our faith. Our way of thinking is attuned to the Eucharist, and the Eucharist, in turn, confirms our way of thinking. Please be seated.
Thank you.
sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
May the gifts of your joyful church be acceptable to you, O Lord, so that your people gathering in this holy house may come through these mysteries to everlasting salvation. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Father most holy. For you have made the whole world a temple of your glory, that your name might everywhere be extolled. Yet you allow us to consecrate to you apt places for the divine mysteries. And so we dedicate joyfully to your majesty this house of prayer, built by human labor. Here is foreshadowed the mystery of the true temple. Here is prefigured the heavenly Jerusalem. For you made the body of your Son, born of the tender virgin, the temple consecrated to you, in which the fullness of the Godhead might dwell. You also established the church as a holy city, built upon the foundation of the apostles, with Christ Jesus himself the chief cornerstone. A city to be built of chosen stones, given life by the Spirit and bonded by charity, where for endless ages you will be all in all, and the light of Christ will shine undimmed forever. Through him, O Lord, with all the angels and saints, we give you thanks as in exaltation we acclaim. grave and saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. As we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and in recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession, in your presence we rely for unfading help.
May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope, Patricio, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family who dedicate this church to you. May it be for you, family, a house of salvation and a place for the celebration of your heavenly sacraments. Hear me the gospel of peace resound, and the sacred mysteries be celebrated, so that your faithful, formed by the word of life and by divine grace, on their pilgrim way through the earthly city, may merit to reach the eternal Jerusalem. There, in your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed brothers and sisters, to all who are pleasing to you. At their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. the Savior's command and from the divine teaching, we dare to say, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. And now let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you.
God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Oh,
Please all rise.
Let us pray. Through these holy gifts we have received, O Lord, we pray. Instill in our minds an increase of your truth, so that we may constantly adore you in your holy temple and glory in your sight with all the saints, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. At this moment, we will witness the signing of the documents of the Diocese of Bacolod and the Franciscans. To celebrate this moment with a round of applause. Thank you. let's listen to some words of acknowledgement.
Father Dante will give the acknowledgement. What I am doing, going to do is to read to you the message from the prior administrators in Bosnia. This is in response to the letter we sent to the Minister Provincial and his definitorium, informing them our efforts in constructing a structure here in Bacolod, replicating the one in Medjugorje. Father Rene Sidiano, FM, Minister Provincial, Cerro Capricorn Street, Pleasant Homes, Punta Princesa, Cebu City, Philippines. Medjugorje, September 3, 2022. Dear Father Rene, Bishop Buzon, beloved Franciscan brothers and people of the Diocese of Bacolod, I am truly happy and excited to hear about your great endeavor to build the same church as it is in Medjugorje in honor of the Blessed Mother, the Queen of Peace, and St. James, the patron saint of the pilgrims. For us Christians, Mary is that humble servant, the great soul who constantly helps us, invites us to her Son, brings messages, and wants the children of this world to inherit peace. Why peace? For peace is the eternal state of the soul. Peace is the foundation of the encounter with God. Peace is the sign of God's presence. Always peace. Where God is present, there is peace. To live peace is to know Christ. So peace becomes our lifestyle, the commandment to make Christ present. Mary is the guardian of memories, the guardian of the events of salvation. She teaches us to keep the memory of God's presence. She is the mother of the presence. We need Mary to keep our faith, to always remind us again what happened. The story of faith preserves the human being. Even though we are 7,000 miles away, we are grateful to share the same faith, the same Mary, the same love for her Son. My Franciscan brothers are truly joyful to know that you are now part of our identity, an important part of Medjugorje's spirituality, the school of Mary. I hope that the day will come when one of our brothers will come to visit you and personally bring you a piece of Medjugorje. Congratulations on this amazing project. May your church truly become the sign of Mary, the sign of peace. On behalf of our Franciscan brothers in Medjugorje and the whole province of the Assumption of the Blessed Mother in Mostar, I send you our fraternal greetings and gratefulness. witness of faith. Thank you also for everybody. Letter D, the Montinola family. Ino's generosity reflected God's providential care. Ino's devotion to the Blessed Mother and Apostle James the Greater made all this day a reflection of all that is good. Tito Tony, Tito Noy, you fulfilled once more the role of being a father, that is a provider and a prayer leader of the family. You provided us with a majestic place to feel God's presence on earth. Tita Chona or Tita Inday, the binding force of the family, imitating the Blessed Mother whose love and care gathered us today. Force of the family, imitating the Blessed Mother whose love and care guided us today. You are an instrument in binding the children of God today as one family. May you see your children's children and may they come to this church to pray and to continue your good and blessed work. A big and unending thank you to you and your children. Trinio Noibadi, Montinola III. Cristina Tintin Montinola Rayos and Maria Chona Chonet, Antonia Montinola Suarez, and the grandchildren, the relatives, guests, and visitors of the Montinola, thank you. May I request the family and the relatives of the Montinola to please stand to be recognized. A round of applause to them. Mahuyagin si Tita Inday o si Tita Tony. Thank you. Letter E. Enthusiast members of the only birthed community, today we celebrate and bless this holy place, a place for us to journey together in communion, participation, and mission. Enthusiast newly organized and is in preparation to be installed lay ministers, lectors and altar servers, and the choir. Enthusiast atis and kuyas in Manaol who help us in preparation our future pastoral leaders. Enthusiast neighbors who said their hi and hellos when we first came, they are at the back of the church. To the enthusiast communities, members of the juridical responsibility of our oratory,
May we come together and begin our journey under the protection of Apostle James and the powerful intercession of Our Lady of Medjugorje. To the enthusiast PPC of the Parish of San Nicolas de Tolentino, who is actively showing the support and assisting us in our pastoral needs, thank you. For letter F, Friars, the Friars of the Agustinian Recollects. Father Antoni Morelio OER, the Parish Priest of San Nicolas, who always tell me, walay problema, Padre. Unsa imong kinahanglan sa parokya, no problem. Thank you. Father Roland Sipid, assistant, my batchmate also in Sojourn, and the Friars of the Agustinians, with your brotherly love and concern, welcome and thoughts of our needs, thank you. Second, to the Friars of the Custody of St. Anthony of Padua, my brothers, welcome. This is our ministry, our new contribution to the mission of our good Lord. Let me introduce to you, and let us give a round of applause, my brother priest of the Franciscan. Please stand. The man in brown. Let me also recognize the presence of our brothers of San Pedro Bautista province, headed by our parish priest of Santuario de San Antonio, Forbes Park, Makati, and the vicar generals and his brothers in the province, Father Rio Galoy, vicar general. We also have here my good friend from my diocese of Kidapawan, my former diocese, Father Boboy Dimenso and Father Janelle Peroy, who are here with us. Thank you. Welcome, brothers, to the City of Smiles, and thank you for coming. Here, we begin our fraternal life, and mindful of what Francis said, let us begin, brothers, for up to this time, we have done nothing. Moving forward to liturgy, the great builders. Before we have this majestic and fascinating church, we have the minds of our engineers and hands who labored. Architect Ramiro Garcia Jr. Engineer Charles Manuel Garcia. Thank you. And padayon gid kita sa aton maayon buluhaton. The hands, all the laborers for the carpentry, scaffoldings, lights, sounds, painting, and mason, all who labored passionately with smiles and shared their craftsmanship, the men and women of Hacienda Manaol, damo gid nga salamat sa inyong mga talent and skills kag magpadayon kita. The iconic friends we met and came to show their support, give their generosity and prayers. We have so many friends from here, from Panay Island, Cebu Province, Negros Island, Manila, Mindanao all the way from Kidapawan, Pagadian, Zamboanga del Sur, Iloilo and Davao, friends of Francis and Claire, friends of Assisi. Thank you. Daghang salamat. Joy, the Franciscan joy to have them here today. The Franciscan Second Order, the Order of St. Clair, our Monja, from the Monastery of St. Clair Antiki Panay. They are our powerhouse of prayer. Thank you for coming, mga Iksuon. Mga kapatid na Franciscano, ang amon mga Third Order, for the religious men and women congregation in the Diocese of Bacolod, damo gid nga salamat. The kapatiran or kapatid of the secular order of Franciscan from different from fraternity, from Bacolod, Iloilo, Mindanao, thank you. Our laudable choir, the angelic voice
and worthy of praise, the choir of Sacred Heart Seminary, thank you. And of course, the masterful liturgists and servers, thank you very much, Father Chad Gayaris and your assistant, for the liturgy and the seminars of the Sacred Heart Seminary, the nameless individuals of the City of Smiles, Bacolod, who also extend their support and prayers to make this day successful. May the good Lord continue to bless you in your humility and generosity. Our vicar guardian, my assistant pastor, Father Ferdinand Ferdi Mercado, OFM. Father Ferdi, let us begin. And with that, we ask your prayers. To all of you, please continue to pray for us as we continue the building process, both of the building and the people of God. That is in letter Q, quality, that we may discern the Holy Spirit within us and see what are lacking and serve it with quality and in humility. And in letter R, resourcefulness, that we may continuously rely on the providence and generosity of God through and reflected by the people, that in our mission we may be, as the letter S, to serve. As Teresa of Calcutta said, if you cannot do them with great love, do them with little love. If you cannot do them with little love, do them anyway. Love grows when people serve. In our togetherness and serving, we share our letter L, take T, talents, time, treasures. And all of this, we may be letter U, useful servants in the letter V, in the vineyard of the Lord, spreading it as in letter W, wide, farthest corner of the earth, not as letter X, Xerox servants, but letter Y, youthful, and letter Z, zealous. My dear brothers and sisters, Diocese of Bacolod, Hacienda Manoal, please join me and Father Ferdi on September 11, this coming Sunday, the first Mass to be celebrated after this dedication at 10 o'clock in the morning, with our choir recruited, newly recruited from Hacienda Manoal. After a month of practice and recruitment with our new choir and the liturgical ministers, they will serve on Sunday. It's their first time to serve. Please join us Sunday, September 11, at 10 o'clock in the morning. Sa inyo nga tanan, damo gid nga salamat. Thank you. After the final blessing, may I request the clergy, and of course our bishop, to have some photo ops, and also with the family, here facing the altar, so that the people will be included in the photo ops. Thank you, and maayong nga hapon sa inyong atanan.
Please all rise for the incensation of the image of Our Lady.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing.
May God, the Lord of heaven and earth, who has gathered you today for the dedication of this church, make you abound in heavenly blessings.
Amen.
Amen.
May God, who has willed that all his scattered children be gathered in his Son, grant that you become his temple and the dwelling place of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
May you be made thoroughly clean, so that God may dwell within you, and you may possess with all the saints the inheritance of eternal happiness.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
The Mass has been offered. Go in peace.
Blessings to
something.